It's cold out there, doesn't it? Anyway, this is an old video card from the early 90s. What we're going to do, we're going to remove, like that, that's the crystal oscillator, it's 27 megahertz. We'll remove that, and that'll be the art of our simple transmitter. Here's the parts for the transmitter, not a lot. So a battery pack, there's the antenna, there's a one capacitor, one 470 ohm resistor, or audio inputs. Right, now this oscillator I pulled from an old 90s video card from a PC. You can get these from old computer motherboards, sound cards, video cards. The four pin, I've marked them up. You've got your battery connectors and your antenna out. We'll only be using the three pins. That's pin one's marked. Yeah. So I don't want to put this into the small breadboard I have. Right, pop that in. Battery connectors in, next. Go live. 5 volts in. Put that in. There you go. On next is the round wire. Just insert that in. There you go. Well, next is the 470 ohm resistor. If you're going to build one of these, make sure you use a 470 ohm or very near. This just helps the frequency pull very slightly, because this is not a voltage controlled oscillator, it's fixed. So we need this in, and it needs to be 470 ohm or very near. And that's in. Well, next is the capacitor. This is a 470 UF. This is for the sound input. There we go. Well, next we're just going to insert the audio input. I've just soldered on a couple of wires onto an audio socket. Put it around that side. It's a bit tricky to do this. An older camcorder at the same time. Sound input in. Oh, I've just got the antenna now. What is our antenna wire? There we go, antenna in, hold on. It's So we've got a resistor in, the crystal oscillator, the cap, audio input, battery input, antenna out. All done. Now this crystal is a 27 megahertz. And this produces a square wave. So basically it's full of harmonics. So this will broadcast on 27 megahertz. 54, 81, 108, 135, and I'm not sure if I'll get an output on 162 megahertz. I'll try it with my scanner. So what we'll do, we'll just plug an audio input in and we'll see how this operates. Well, I've got the input in there, got the volume up a little. Pop our battery in. There we go. Let's turn our frequency counter on. Have we got an output? Yep. Right, so we know it's working. So what we'll do, pop downstairs and use my scanner to tune in. You can use a standard FM radio to pick these little crystals up. The sound won't be brilliant, only a very, very simple construction in it. So here's my scanner. So the crystals are 27 megahertz, so we should get an output or a sound output on 54 and 81 and 108. Okay, that's there you go.
Goldstein and Jason.
That's what's written there.
Danny Kelly in charge of kickoff at 7. Drive, it's Goffey.
That's 1 megahertz.
Goffey, and the A-team will be here at 1.
Let's try.
And Jay. And incidentally, there's another angle of the incident last night.
There you go. Not saying this is a scanner, but you should put the frequency up. Now, as a standard, this is a good Chinese radio. But like I say, it's more of an AM output on the transmitter than a proper, you know, FM output. That's because it's a fixed crystal. I might make a video soon with a voltage-controlled crystal oscillator. I'll get a bit more pull on the frequency, so I'll get a better FM output. There we go. Amazing, isn't it?
You've been punished.
Only a couple of components.
Yeah, the kid's got his 77,000 followers on Twitter.
Right, so 1 megahertz.
Do you have?
And you can hear the sound output. Basically, it's the most simplest crystal transmitter you could ever build, you know. Improve the circuit. No, there's a lot you can do with that type of circuit.
Please
subscribe to my channel and view my other videos.
Yeah.